This is David John Murata with Murata Wealth Management. In this part one, we review the IRA tax laws, and in part two, we will apply those laws in a technique called Roth segregation accounts. With a traditional IRA, contributions are tax deductible for middle and lower income families, and the values grow tax deferred. But as you withdraw the money, you have to pay ordinary income tax rates on it. If your tax rate is lower in retirement when you take the money out than it was when you originally received the tax deduction, a traditional IRA account can offer great benefits. Upper income families don't get a tax deduction if they're an active participant in an employer plan. However, they can still contribute to a traditional IRA. Money they put in that didn't qualify for the tax deduction still grows tax deferred. But when they withdraw the money, their tax liability is lower. Traditional IRAs are also subject to required minimum distributions, or RMDs. Starting at age 70 and a half, owners of traditional IRAs must take a certain percentage out of the account and pay ordinary income tax. The government requires the withdrawals because it wants to start collecting tax on the money. But because account values have dropped so much lately, Congress has waived the RMD in 2009. The government evidently wants account values to recover to maximize the taxes collected. With a second type of retirement account, the Roth IRA, there is no tax deduction when you deposit the money. You must pay the tax on the income first and then contribute to the Roth. And only middle and lower income families are permitted to contribute. The investments grow tax-free rather than tax-deferred. Qualified distributions from Roth IRAs are not subject to any income taxes. Roth IRAs are to your advantage if your tax rate is higher in retirement when you withdraw the money than it was when you contributed. With a Roth IRA, you pay tax on the acorn. With a traditional IRA, you pay tax on the oak. Many families have actually lost money by investing in their traditional IRA when they were young and in a lower tax bracket, only to find themselves in a much higher bracket during their retirement. In fact, so much money has accrued in retirement accounts that if it were all withdrawn today, it could pay off a significant percentage of the federal deficit. In fact, you can do just that. In a Roth conversion, you take money from your traditional IRA, pay tax as though that money is ordinary income, and convert it to a Roth IRA. Currently, only middle and lower income families can do this, but the law changes in 2010, allowing families with any level of income to convert to a Roth. If you execute a Roth conversion in January of year one, you may not have to pay the tax on that conversion until April 15th of year two. You also may change your mind. If you decide the conversion wasn't worth it, or you were over the income limits allowed for a conversion in 2009, you can move the money from the Roth account back to a traditional IRA account. This is called a Roth recharacterization. Recharacterizing a Roth conversion can be done any time before you file your taxes, including the filing extension. So you can change your mind any time before October 15th of year two. And you can decide to recharacterize part or all of what you converted. In the midst of all these changing tax laws, the tax rates are also in flux. At the end of 2010, the Bush tax cuts will expire. The Obama administration is not expected to alter the rates significantly before then. They don't want to be blamed for raising taxes before the midterm elections, and they would rather implicate the previous administration for a crazy expiring tax law. Until then, tax rates are at a historic low. After 2010, counting all the tax changes, top marginal rates will probably rise from 44.6% to 62.4%. Thus, you will only have to pay a maximum of 44.6% on income you take before 2011. But after that, you may have to pay 17.8% more in tax. The upside is that you can use all these laws and changes to gain an extra 30% on your investments. But it needs to be put together as part of a larger plan. For additional information or a hard copy to give to your financial advisor, please visit our website.